Hello and welcome to a new tutorial video. In this video, we will make like dynamic decal. I can show how it's going to work. So when you shoot, it spawns that decal that has like first this yellowish color, like emissive color, and then it slowly goes to normal. Just like that. So let's start. Okay, I will make that dynamic like bullet hole into my FPS course project. But if you haven't followed my FPS course, I recommend you do it, but it's not mandatory. So we will make bullet holes. When bullet hits, it spawns that decal here and it has like dynamic material. So we are going to start here, where is our shoot ray. And this function is shooting ray. And we have that line trace by channel. And then we have follow camera. That is our camera. And each word location will be starting point of that ray. And end point will be forward vector. So like direction to forward. And we multiply it by range. So how far. And then we add those together. We get vector. And that's the end result. And trace channel is currently camera. And then we have this break hit result that you can do by clicking here, break. And we will spawn that bullet hole, I think, here after dealing damage. If you want to spawn different types of bullet holes to different like materials, you can spawn that bullet hole here, for example, in metal section. If actor has stuck metal here, or if it's flesh, you can spawn like blood decal to it. But yeah, we will spawn it here. And what we are going to do, we need to first make a transform. Sorry, I'm a little bit ill. So make transform. And here. Location will be hit location, so where that line trace hits. And then we need to make rotation for that decal, so it points to camera always, or no camera, like forward vector of wall, for example. So basically, if decal goes here, it points like this direction. If it goes floor, it points upwards. And that's what we want to do. So we need to take normal and then rotation from X vector. Rotation from X vector. And that will be our rotation. And we can modify that scale later if we need. Then we can spawn actor from glass. This one. And spawn transform will be this transform. And I think we don't have to do anything else here. But we need the class. So we have to actually make that. It tells us error because we don't have any class attached. So now you can create new blueprint class. So create blueprint class and it would be basic class. Then we can call it BB underscore bullet hole. Then we can open it. And here we need decal. And we don't have any decal material for it, probably. So you can find your own textures, but I will search if I find anything here. Quixel bridge. Then let's go to the decals and let's take some decal that is close to bullet hole that we can get. What could be like sphere? I think this is okay for now. Let's use that one. You can download it low quality because this will be very small. So Then download and then press add. And now it is added to our project. We have now this concrete patch. But we need probably make new material for it. And let's create new material. _ dynamic decal. And here we need to press that one and change this to be deferred decal. Then we can set this to be translucent. Yep, and then we can put base color. Let's see how it looks. Then we can take normal map, put it to normal, and then we need to find like opacity. And opacity probably in this case is blue channel. So let's close this. So connect blue channel to opacity. So now we have opacity. But then we need also have emissive color, and that will be that dynamic thing. So how to make emissive color? Press 3 on your keyboard and then click. It makes vector. Then press 1 and click. It makes like single number. Then press M to get multiply. You can of course share this also multiply. But yeah, connect this and connect that to emissive color. And this will be our strength. So we need to convert it to parameter and call it emissive _boost. And let's make some default value, for example, 4. And this is color. So now you can choose some color. For example, this orange color. Yeah, that looks good. Then compile and save. Now go to your bullet hole back, and here we need to find that what we created and put it here. And now we need to make sure it is, let's actually try. Yeah, it's way too large. So press that decal and then select that one and scale it down. Probably like 0.05 could be good. Yeah, it looks good. Then we can make it a little bit smaller. Maybe 0.3. Then compile and save. And now we have bullet decal. What we are going to do next, we go to event graph. Actually, we want the life span. So this is when this actor gets destroyed when it's spawned. So maybe like 10 seconds. We don't want to like make a huge garbage to our game if we have like millions of bullet holes. So maybe 10 seconds could be a good time. Then, what we need, you can delete those, and let's use this begin play. Take your decal, and then find create dynamic material instance. Then you can promote this return value to variable, and call it dynamic material instance. Now we have this, and now we can call set scalar parameter value. And here, parameter name is that same name what we have here, emissive boost. So you can copy that and paste it here. But now, this value is this value. So we want to first it be 4, and then smoothly go to 0. And One way to do it could be timeline. Let's actually use timeline. So find timeline and then put it play from start. It doesn't matter really. And update goes here. And now we need to make this timeline. So press this button, add track, add flow track. And how long it takes to turn that color back to normal. Let's make something like 1 second. Could be okay. Then add key and add second key. That first key, yes, time and value. Time will be 0, so it starts from beginning, and value will be that 4. Then second key, value will be 0, and time will be 1, so end of that timeline. Then compile and save, go to back to your event graph, and now you have this new track. You can plug it here, and this will be that variable that we created. We could also use that one, but we have no variable, so why don't we use that? Double click and make this, and you can delete that one. So now it should work. We can try. Simulate. Oh, we have errors here. So find that bb underscore decal. No. Bullet hole. Yeah, that one. Bullet hole. Then compile and save. And let's try. Yeah, it works. Now we can delete that one. We don't need that anymore. Now we can actually try how it works. It could be a little bit smaller and you should have some like correct decal for bullets. These are not really looking like bullet holes. And why those are black? It's because those are rotated wrong. So open your bullet hole and then go to viewport, and here we can actually test how it works. Put it here, then select 90 degrees. We can check right away. Because this is rotated wrongly, it should be like this, but now it's like this. So we can do it here. Press that button, then rotate it like this. Then compile and save. We can also make it a little bit smaller even. Maybe 0.01. Maybe 2. Oh, I said it wrong. This should be like this. Yeah, 0.2 and 0.02. Let's test. Yeah, now it's working. But if you haven't followed my tutorial, you can just copy these nodes and then make some input event that I have here. This kind of input event. You can also make any key event you want, for example F6, then you can change that to be mouse by clicking, and pressed will be that. But yeah, fire rifle and then shoot ray. We have one problem, and probably it's not a problem, but if you want, you can make this replicated also, because currently if we shoot, we can see that bullet hole, but other player can see. So how are we going to do that? It's pretty easy. You can go your event graph, multiplayer events, and create new custom event. So custom event and spawn bullet hole. And make this to be run on server and reliable. So it always spawn no matter what. And then we can copy this spawn actor to here, and now we can leave that and spawn transform, make input, then compile and save, and remember that name, you can copy it, and here you can call that event like that. Then just connect these, press control while connecting these, and you can delete that one. But still it would not work because we are spawning it to server, but only server knows that we are spawning it there. So we have to replicate this whole actor so other players can also see, like clients. You can search replicates and set it to be true. Then compile and save, and let's try. Yeah, it is working. If you want like some more stuff, you can for example delete that from here and put this only to metal here. And then connect this transform to here. So now if we shoot other player, it doesn't spawn it. But you can of course make multiple these and then change that decal to be some blood decal or something. But yeah, thanks for watching and see you next video. Bye.